My name is Sophie Rebecca, and as part of my entourage was my mother, Rachel.
Look at that.
Oh, no, you keep doing this.
I know, but look at that.
I don't want fishtail. My cousin, Alicia, and my aunt, Dee.
Yes, we're not leaving here today until you're in happy tears.
Yes, we have to find a dress today. There's obviously a lot of baggage that comes as being a trans woman. So to be in this position is quite amazing. I want big princess ball gown, as big as possible, to make me look smaller.
Sophie, hi, gorgeous. How are you?
Cock, nice to meet you.
Hey, Mom, how are you? How are you doing?
Looking forward to you finding the dress.
How long have you been looking, Mum?
This is the fifth time we've been out.
The fifth time. Yeah, Sophie, what are you doing? Causing
not
chaos
the dress.
And mayhem.
It's her idea of hell is dress shopping, and I've dragged her. This is the fifth time I've dragged her.
I do need to know about your fiancé.
Yes. I met her 6 years ago, or just over 6 years ago, and I just can't imagine life without her. My fiancée is Sandy, and she is an amazing, strong woman.
I think the thing that I love most about Sophie is her bravery. She has taken this huge decision to be herself in a world that's not very friendly.
Sandy's given me the courage and the bravery to be who I am, and she's stood by me when I have. I love you, sausage.
So have you thought about the style?
Yeah, like, I'm conscious of the size of my shoulders, so I originally wanted a sleeve dress to cover them up, but then we found that sleeveless actually seemed to work quite well for me. And, yeah, I want a big princess gown because, well, I'm a princess, but also because it makes me look smaller.
We are going to guide you in the right place to make sure that you feel comfortable. Okay, so let's spin you around. Let's find out from your gorgeous entourage what they think.
I love the skirt and I love the train and the buttons at the back. I would like to see a little bit more bling. It's a bit plain.
I like the top better than I like the skirt, and I don't quite know why.
What do you like about the skirt?
I'm not sure.
Is it too full?
It can never be too full.
Yes, possibly. Yeah, it fits beautifully, but there isn't the wow factor in that dress.
How do you feel about the straps? Because it's been quite controversial upstairs.
Well, no, I like the straps. I think the straps kind of follow the line of the dress.
It does. It's
from shoulder to floor.
Yeah. Did he feed you that?
No.
Just happens, it's just the truth.
It is good to see that Gok's influence is working on Sophie and broadening her outlook and her horizons.
Tell us what you think.
I think it's a little bit plain.
Let's try another dress with a slightly different shape or another detailing and see how you react to that. I think that you've seen your shape for the first time today.
Yeah, it's enhanced my good features.
Exactly.
So I'm seeing good features now.
There you go. It's working!
It would be an incredible disappointment if Sophie didn't get her moment.
What we wanted to do is to stand there and smile and say, this is perfect.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
It's wonderful to see her grinning ear to ear.
What can I say? I love the hips, I love the waist. Even I have to admit, I look beautiful. I can't stop smiling.
What do you think, Mum?
I think you genuinely feel that you look as lovely as you do.
I so want to hate it.
I can't begin to tell you how wonderful it is to hear Sophie expressing her contentment with who she's become at this point in her life.
It's really tough, isn't it? Because you've now seen all of your figure on show, but you also really want that princess gown.
This dress with a bigger skirt.
Well, why don't you let me have the control, Sophie? Let's go. So, Sophie, my darling, I know I've now put the cat among the bridal pigeons by going back to the fuller skirt. Well, let's maybe find out from your gorgeous entourage what they think. Mum?
I love the top. I love the way it fits you, gives you a lovely shape, but I don't think it complements you as much as number two.
Your figure was shown off more in the last dress, but this is really beautiful also. Tricky.
You've been no help. Today I've had an epiphany or a transformation or whatever word you want to use that has changed me as a person significantly. I mean, it's been an amazing day. I was here to find a wedding dress, and in a strange way I found myself. And we've tried on so many dresses, I've never been able to look past my own body. And you've given me that. But now you give me two bloody dresses. I am now totally torn by these two dresses. I just need more time to decide.
I didn't see this coming at all.
Do you know what, ladies? The lovely Sophie has fought so hard for her body, her identity. I think for the first time in her life, she feels beautiful and sexy, and I think she's chosen well. And I hope you agree.
Praying that at the end of the day, she goes with the butterfly that's emerged, and she goes for dress two. She looks $1 million.
Do you feel beautiful?
I do feel beautiful.
I think you look beautiful as well.
She looks proud and happy and confident. Everything that you would want a bride to look. She looks... Who could ask for more?
Yeah.
So, Sophie, a very big and important question for you. Are you going to say yes to the dress?
God, absolutely, I'm saying yes to this dress.
Well done!
In terms of who I am as a person, if the only or the first thing you notice about me is that I'm transgender, is you've missed everything else about me.